Here we go. Good morning, sheep fans. Cammy's the name, sheep's the game. It's not the morning, it's actually the afternoon because we had a wet start to the day. So we're late starting. We're on the shearing again here. Got my shearing bucket looking cool as. We've got a fair squad with us here. Let me just get a wee step back and show you this. We're at the McLean's, a south side. It's a fair place this, lots of grass down near Troon. Prime land, the kind of place you dream of having a farm. But for Robert and the family, it's actually reality. Here we go, here's the ewes. Tremendous ewes, Robert's up to his numbers. I think we showed about 60 for him last year, and now we've got 140. So it's exciting. Mary, his daughter, who's right here, very keen on sheep, so Robert's facilitating that habit, as we might call it. Look this up here, health and safety. Beautiful, can't go wrong. Beautiful. What a setup, we're on the three strand trailer here today because we're gonna have Jock shearing with us, we're gonna have me shearing with us, and we're gonna have Lizzie doing some on the end there.
Can I get a head start in case Lizzie beats me?
I told her not to do too many, just to take it easy. Aye. You'll be fine. You'll be fine, Jock. We don't talk about tallies here, just my tallies. I don't embarrass any of you guys. Exciting, get into the shearing. Is it exciting? I don't know if that's the right term or not. It's a serious thought, that's what it is. Let's finish getting set up. Hey man, I just got an interview here, your first year lambing 140 sheep, was it?
Yeah, no, 110.
You quite enjoying being a shepherd?
Yes.
Better than cattle?
Yeah, less scary.
That's exactly how I feel about them as well. Less chance of getting kicked and a broken leg and all these other things that come with cattle. But I mean, obviously cattle are great as well for all the cattle fans out there. But we like sheep. Yeah. And are we going up the numbers more?
Yeah, I think so.
Great answer. I see. And there's a lot of grass out here needing eating, so what, maybe another 100?
Yeah, dad goes one day we'll get more, and then the next day is no for having any more.
I have a feeling that after this day, he might say we're not having any more.
Yeah, we'll have none.
No. She says some days dad says we'll get more, and some days he says we'll get less. I think this will be one of the days where you'll say you'll have a bit less.
50-50,
I think looking at all the grass out there, you could handle a few more, eh?
I know. This year's exceptional, though.
Great growth of spring. Looking at it, I thought you'd put a sprinkle on. I was going to chastise you for it because you're not needing it.
It's not worth 800 pounds to feed the sheep, is it?
No, that's it, exactly. And that's another great thing about working with sheep, though. You don't need as much fertiliser. There's just so many perks. Plus you get us in all the time, right? We'll finish getting set up here and get started. So Lizzie asked a good question there about comb selection for this job. Now these are mule ewes, fairly bare of the belly. They look like they've got not a bad rise. I think there'll be a few sticky ones because they're not particularly long lambed, but they're on a fantastic thrive because there's just so much grass here. So generally these ones can shear a little bit earlier than like mine that are having quite a hard life. So for this, what I'm going to do, not because I actually don't have really my gear organised yet, but we're going to use a Super Quasar, which is a new comb. Wow, which is a new comb from Heiniger.
Let go, John.
Jeez. Oh, what a grip. Which is a new comb from Heiniger last year. And let me tell you the details of it. So 95mm wide, short bevel comb. And the super part generally on combs means that it's run in. So you can buy a quasar that's full thickness, but this super quasar's run in. And generally speaking, all the combs I buy will be run in. And what am I using? We're going to try these super quasars this year because I tried them. I got one sent through behind a gun. I used it and I quite liked it. So I thought we'll get a couple of boxes of these. Although I've gave one to Jock already. He's got a box of them. We're going to use these super quasars. We're going to use quantums as always. But on big, we'll call them fat ewes because they will be quite fat. Big fat ewes like this. We can use a wider comb, which this is, 95mm. Not too much lead, because I do anticipate there'll be the odd sticky one here. So we're keeping it within a couple of mils of lead, and then we tighten it up. But I've left my screwdrivers in here. Another great wee tip for folks, somebody asked me what this was for in a previous video. This is my gear pot, so you put your dirty gear in here. It's a tub from, well, it's another Heiniger brand as well, Illustrator. However you want to see it. And your rubber rings come in that, but what I like about it is, well, one, it's got a nice wee handle, good for filling it with water, And the other thing is, the lid is absolutely solid, like it doesn't bounce off. Lizzy uses something like this, which is very, very common as well. But I like my wee gear pot there. It's a good wee bucket, eh? Throw that in there. Get the moccasins on, let's get started.
How's that?
Oh, hi.
Hey, I've got the microphone, I'm not able to hear them.
Hi. Right, well that's the ewes done, back out to grass. You see I'm walking like a cripple again. Just a cold breeze on the back, and the back just not used to it. It's fair softened me up. But hey, we grit our teeth and we keep going, folks.
Ewes done.
7 tups to do now. Hi, how come we've got 110 ewes and 7 tups? Make sure. To be fair, they did scan well, didn't they? Aye. Do you only have your empty at scanning, or what was it again? Nain empty. That's right. Nain, aye. Two must have slit. Aye. Nain empty. Aye. You can't fault them then. Fault them at shearing time when I've got 7 tups today for 110 sheep, but on my back. Lizzy, will you get us falling off the trailer, please?
You're ready, aren't we, Jock?
Yeah. Okay, so we're finished there, as you saw, the big tup's off and we're back with Farmer Mary here, and as always, I like to just get a bit of feedback on what they thought of the whole shearing experience there. Mary, how was that for you?
I just think, thank God Lizzy was here. That was, she was the biggest help out of everyone. I don't think we could have done it without her.
Lizzy, yeah, Lizzy's amazing. Right, thanks Mary, cheers. On to the next job. Lizzy is amazing, obviously. And we're at the next job, folks. It's not a big job, but there's some big sheep. We have 30 ewe hogs to do. We have, what are they? They're like Cheviot mules. Yeah, Cheviot mules, Texel crosses. Well, that's like a Border Leicester or a half-bred, that thing. It's a beast. Suffolk crosses. Some variety you get here on the sheep game. That is definitely, that would be like a pure Border Leicester, I think. Look at the ears on that. Look at the ears on that. Wow. Okay, sheep fans, that was easy bit done. We just did the hogs there while I gave the camera a little charge. You don't want to see too much shearing, do you? Me crippled jock with the big arms and this whole life ahead of him. How I envy your youth and vigour. So yes, that was the hogs done. There's 20 odd tups to do, as I say. Ah, most of them they're just hogs and that, they're no big sizes, but these borders will be a bit of fun. So what we'll do is we'll get into these and we'll switch on for these Border Leicester monsters. Yeah, okay, I'll talk you through this, folks, what I'm thinking in my head. First thing I'm thinking is, if I'd stuck in a bit more at school, I could have went to Heriot-Watt University and became an actuary. But instead, I joined the police, and then later decided that wasn't for me, and I wanted to be a sheep shearer. And then I end up in situations like this. But that's okay, you know, it's a nice evening here in Ayrshire. It's a big sheep, but she's not that big. I've seen bigger. That's what she said. Let's get started. You notice with that first leg, I tuck it under my ulster. I don't try and tuck it under my leg, because if I tuck it under my leg and he decides that he doesn't want to be shown, he sends me flying towards the pickup there. So it's all about doing the things that keep me alive, really, here. So belly's off, nice and easy. Flick that way. You see that wee scratching its leg? That was the knee. Well, it might have got that off the door on the way out. Now working around the testicles here, we're being very careful. Not to upset them, because if he starts kicking, he's probably too heavy for me to stop. Flick that leg out, he thinks about going, but I say no, hold on, big man. We'll get you through this. You're going to enjoy it. You're quite nice shearing, actually, now we've got into this. So you've got nothing to complain about. You should be enjoying yourself. Enjoying the whole process. The wool's coming off nice. Comb and cutter's working away fine, despite it having done quite a lot of sheep already. Take a wee bit off your top knot there. Oh, and then stepping up the neck's not easy because he's so tall. So we keep him at a slight angle. We've got this big long neck. Nearly made it. And out the cheek. Working away, just constantly thinking, keeping him happy. I'm feeling for him tensing up and throwing me off. If I can get him onto these longos, I can relax a little bit, because then the pressure's off me, off my legs. Holding him here, it's Jock. Pan round to Jock. Jock, you've just taken the shine right off of what I'm doing here. Get a nice photo in there, Jane, that's it. I reckon I can make a million view TikTok out of this. Tiny arms shears big sheep. So I'm working away here, and what I'm thinking is, if I get this one finished quick enough, I'll be able to catch Jock's one before it gets away. Something not right with that dropper there, eh? Can you ruin all the nice things I gave you? I think that's going to, it's going to give up on itself, I think. Right, pop you through. I'll not worry too much about the ridges, because it's hard enough just getting the wheel off of him, I should say. Oh, big Marky, calm down. Oh, big Marky. Calm down here, boy. Oh, big Marky, you're all right.
Oh, steady now, you're just getting an awkward angle. And I'm getting myself in an awkward position. Oh, this wee scratch, we've caught his leg somehow. Maybe the dunk had a wee nip at him. Don't blame the shearer. As we get round this last couple blows, finish this wee bit off and let him go. Go, big lad. Go, big lad. Whew.
Yeah. Lovely lighting. Oh, lovely lighting. I don't see the ridges. You'll hardly see them.
Get me in
it. Aye. You'll hardly see it. It's looking great. Good work.
So the man that used to have him used to clip him standing up.
I better write some tallies down. Right, folks. I'm worried sick. I'm worried sick. Day 90 sheep, it's too big a day for him. Anyway, the team are quite chilled out here at Craigie Farming Co. All very happy. That's the hogs and tups done. Just leaves about 500 yards here later in July, early July, very early July. So, yeah, good bit of fun. Good day out. Have you enjoyed yourself, Marissa?
Yeah.
Oh, nearly missed the bag. That's smooth. She's very smooth. See that?
I'm not tired.
She's that tired. Anyway, had a good one, folks. Hope you enjoyed it. Here's the tally as we're sitting just now. We'll keep it running all the time. And we'll see you for the next one.